You might think programming a character to jump is a simple bam, boom, bop. This jump forced me to undergo a 6-month entire game rewrite. I wasted my life for this, and you are gonna find out why with me.
Addy.
At the start of the year, I spent 2 weeks making a Western arcade shooter called High Moon. People liked it, they liked the sword, they liked the gun, so I decided to make it a bigger project. But there was one request that kept coming up.
A jumping mechanic would be cool.
I would like to see some
Addy,
jumping.
Please call us. We haven't heard from you in months. Your father and I are getting...
Now hold tight, baby birds. Daddy wants to lay a big fat worm on you, but it's just squirming too much. Sure, I could just add a little jump. See? But what's the point if there's nothing to even jump over? There's rocks and cactuses, but you can just dodge around them. So a jump is pretty useless. No, what you really want is something hip that the kids will like a wall or a big gaping pit. Those are cool to jump over and pretty easy to add. Or so you'd think. In my game, there's no gravity, no physics. Heck, even the movement is a lie. It's all an illusion. He just passed through that wall. The way I had all done up was that the player was in one place while everything moved towards them. The ground is actually just a flat plane with a scrolling texture. Now, there's a couple of benefits for doing something this way. One, locking the player to just one axis really simplifies things. You can just clamp their X position so they don't move onto the edges, onto the fence, onto your girlfriend. And two, the only thing you need to render are a handful of sprites, a single 3D plane, and the occasional house. It's easy on the engine, it's easy on your graphics card, and easy on the eyes.
What are you looking at? Wait, no, no. What's that for? I don't want any part of it!
For how quickly I made the game, this system works really well, but if we wanted to add a pit, do we just cut a hole in the scrolling texture? Because I did that, and honestly, it just kind of looks like shit. Ideally, we would have fully realized 3D crevasses and platforms to leap between, but our old system really can't handle any of that. The player and the level don't even talk to each other. They don't even know the other one exists. And they're gonna have to if we're gonna get those pits and walls
we truly desire.
We're gonna have to write a complete rendering and collision system from scratch.
Here at Addy Labs, we work on the exciting technology of today's video games tomorrow. Our team of scientists have been working hard to bring our overproduced collision and rendering systems to games that probably don't need them. Addy dear, tell the nice people, how are you going to bring the power of 3D collisions to our clearly 2D friend here?
Thank you. Baymaker is a 2D engine, so 3D collisions don't really work out of the box. I could have switched to something like Unity, but, I mean, sometimes it's not that much better. When doing 3D physics systems
for a... dear. When doing 3D physics systems for a 2D game engine, you can do a couple of things. Don't. Or, implement something that we here call the square prismoid data table. An SPDT is similar to a data table that stores data for tile-based collisions.
Oh, I've heard of this. One means there's a collision,
yes, one
zero
means there's a collision, and zero means there's no collisions at all. I told you to stop. A square prismoid is the name we've given to represent a square taken into the third dimension. Nice job, dear.
Thanks, Professor Addy.
That's Daddy T.
Yeah, I'm done with this bit. To implement such a system would require writing each section of cell in the grid by hand, and you probably could guess how annoying that'd get. And that doesn't even cover the visual aspect. You have a character running around colliding with invisible walls, so you'd have to use a 3D model. But, like I said, GM don't do 3D, so you would need to code the collisions and the 3D model by hand. Or skip that hell and live in one of your own making. Just spend time making a tool that'll automate that process for you. What? I like making tools.
Get out of my face!
But ain't she pretty? My job can fire me, take my income away.
But they can't take you, baby.
This little DZ helps me build levels straight Minecraft style and export them, hit the microphone, into separate collision and 3D model files, which can then be interpreted on the game maker side. Now, I'm sure it wouldn't have taken so long if I didn't waste time messing with the graphic design.
UI UX UI UX.
It does what we want. It's great. We can export the raw collision and model file and get it cooking in game. I'm an egg. But Game Maker, she's not ready for us yet. See, High Moon is an infinite runner game. You know, infinite level. What are you gonna do? Load the level all at once? That's like forever polygons. That's ridiculous. No. So instead, the level needs to be split up into manageable bite-sized chunks. So in the editor, I made sure to add a feature where you can make multiple different chunks, string them together into a list that the game can choose at random. You can edit that list, take things off. I mean, look, you don't want to go to your grandma's house anymore? Fine, she's out of here. I don't even have to touch an ounce of code. Keep my hands clean.
Oh, what the fuck?
I also added a feature to import 3D models. Look at that. See this? This is you. And this is the fence she tells you not to worry about.
Will I ever release it? Probably not.
Now we've got our level chunks loading in. Now we just need to add our player in and get the collision system working. The first thing that we do... Yeah, there's like a billion collision detection systems on YouTube. They all pretty much just do the same thing. So you can just skip this part. I mean, while we're here, I mean, I got a haircut and you haven't really, said anything. And voila, our player is moving perfectly around. And you got side collisions and die collisions. This is exactly what I wanted. Rewriting the whole system in this way has a lot of benefits, but makes some other things harder. With real collisions at play, enemies won't be able to ghost through walls anymore. I mean, which may require us to write a whole pathfinding system, and we'll get into that in another video, because this video is about jumping. Or did you forget? Don't trust what those YouTube game developers tell you. This is the easy part. Look at that. Did it in like 5 minutes. And now we can answer the question. Was it worth all that time? Probably not. But let's raise the stakes. We don't have to just jump over pits. We can jump off ledges.
Hey!
On buildings.
Hey!
Off walls.
Hey!
Don't you